Feeling like taking a coffee break? So do I. What about we talk about JEP 280, Indify String Concatenation, delivered in a JDK 9 in 2017. Yeah, I know, that's another old JEP. But, you know, there are many folks out here, maybe you're one of them, still using the JDK 8 for their app, and they need incentive arguments to move to a more recent version of the JDK. And trust me, this JEP is a very good one. Indify String Concatenation. Indify, what does that mean? Yeah, sometimes the technical jargon, geeky details can leak into the title of a JEP. Ever heard about leaky abstractions? Maybe we could call that a leaky geek traction. It comes from the bytecode instruction called Invokedynamic, also known as Indy, thus Indify. It has been added to the JDK 7 and is used in the JDK 8 to implement lambda expressions, among other things. And it turns out that this nifty instruction is super useful and used in many places, including string concatenation, as described in this JEP. This JEP has been delivered in a JDK 9 a long time ago and is among the nice things that you will get for free if you move your application from 8 to 11, or even better, to 17. What are the motivations of this JEP? Well, you know, a lot of time is spent working on strings in applications, including concatenating them. This JEP is there to optimize string concatenation, to make it faster, and allow for further optimizations in the future without having to change your code or even to recompile it. You know that you have at least 4 or 5 different patterns to concatenate strings in a JDK. If you still think that using the String Builder is the way to go, maybe you can consider watching this JEP Café, you may learn one thing or two. First thing first, you know that the string class is immutable. You cannot modify a string of characters once it has been created. So writing this could create a first string, the concatenation of hello and a blank space, and then a second string to concatenate the string with world. And if you do that, the concatenation of hello and a blank space would be garbage directly because nothing would point to it. The recommended pattern at some point was to use a string builder to concatenate strings of character. The StringBuilder class is mutable, so you can add content to a StringBuilder. So this code was the recommended way to concatenate strings. This is really a leaky abstraction, a real one this time. You use this pattern only because string is immutable. But in fact, if you check the bytecode of this method, you can see that the compiler does this job for you. It does create this string builder and append to it for you. So there are many simple cases where explicitly writing a string builder is in fact not needed. What if you need to concatenate the elements of a list, for instance? Well, the compiler does its job, but unfortunately it does not work so well in this case. You see, first, there is the for loop in a bytecode, and then the string builder is created. So, in fact, the compiled code creates one string builder in each iteration. So, in that case, writing this code by hand, even if it's not very nice, even if it is still a leaky abstraction, well, it will probably be more efficient. And yes, that's another leaky abstraction, and no one likes that. Great, so what is this JEP 280 about? In a nutshell, it is about replacing this bytecode compiled with the JDK 8 by this one compiled with the JDK 9. What is the difference? Well, concatenation is now handled by a call to Invokedynamic, which delegates the concatenation itself to some other code. In this example, this is the makeConcatWithConstants method of the string concat factory. It is in the JDK, you can look for it if you wish. Delegating the concatenation logic to some code that is not in the bytecode of your class is in fact extremely powerful. The concatenation logic can be optimized from one version of the JDK to the other, and your code will benefit from it without having to recompile it. This is one of the many benefits you will get from moving from the JDK 8 to 11, or even better, to 17. Okay, let us now talk about performances. To measure the performance of some Java code, there is one tool called JMH, which stands for Java Micro Benchmark Harness. All the measurements I'm going to show you have been done with JMH. Of course, the exact numbers are highly dependent on my machine, the machine I am working on. Your CPU is not the same, your memory is not the same, your operating system may also be different. All this has an impact on the numbers. So if you need to benchmark some of your code, there are several principles that you need to follow. First principle, use JMH. This is the only reliable tool you can use to measure the performances of your code. It has been made to measure in-memory computations and does not work as well with input-output. Second, use a configuration as close as possible to the one you have in production. Especially if you are running your app in a virtual machine or in a container, you can observe differences between this environment and your development machine. And third, avoid using a laptop, or if you do so, make sure that all your power-saving features are disabled. They may have an impact on the performances of your machine and can show up without you being aware. This may lead to inconsistent results from one run to the other. Let us take a look at the first benchmark and see the results. In this benchmark, we are just concatenating two strings together, and in the second one, four strings together. Then we run JMH, which produces the following results with the JDK 8 and the following one with the JDK 17. You could deduce here that the JDK 17 is faster than the JDK 8, and that's it. Well, you need to be a little more cautious than that. JMH tells you that the result is 20.9 nanoseconds plus or minus 0.16. What does it mean? It means that there is a 90% chance that the result is between 20.9 plus 0.32 and 20.9 minus 0.32. Where does this 0.32 come from? To understand that, you need to go back to your normal distribution 101 lesson. 0.32 is the double of the error. If you assume that your measure follows a normal distribution, then this error is in fact the standard deviation, and with normal distributions, 90% of the value you measure are between the average and the double of the standard deviation. If you're not comfortable with this 90% and want to go up to 99% of the values, then you need to go up to 3 times the standard deviations. That's it for the normal law. So it means that the measure for the JDK 8 is probably between 20.6 and 21.2. And if you do the same for the JDK 17, you will find that the performance of the same code is probably between 19.4 and 20.9. So yes, from that, you can deduce that there is indeed a difference, not a big one, but still about 5% in favor of the JDK 17. At this point, you may be wondering, what about using string builders? I was told to use string builders and not plain concatenation. Well, you were told that because it is true in certain cases. But whoever told you that only told you half of the story. Because clearly, both in Java 8 and 17, using plain string concatenation is much faster than appending to a string builder, as shown on these graphs. Is it the case for all the cases? Quite not. If you check this piece of code, where you concatenate elements in a loop, then the result is different, because the compiler will in fact create one instance of the string builder in each iteration, as you saw it in a bytecode previously. And this is a performance hit. What you really want to compare is this code, plain concatenation in a loop, to this one, append in a loop, with only one string builder created outside of the loop. And if you do that, then there is no match. Appending is much faster in the JDK 8 and the JDK 17. Okay, concatenating strings is not just about strings. It is also about strings and numbers. And for that, you have two tools in your toolbox. The first one is plain conversion, and the second one is formatting. Let us start with converting numbers to strings of characters. Let me show you three patterns to convert an integer to a string of character. The first one consists in calling integer.toString, plain and simple. There is also integer.valueOf that does the same, but in fact, it calls the integer.toString method, so we do not expect difference in performances. The second one is a little dangerous. Be careful, because it will be frowned upon by your code reviewer. You can just concat an empty string to an int. Never do that in your code. This is bad practice. Okay, calm down. We will see that. And the third and last one is there to show you that sometimes a tiny difference in your code may make a not-so-tiny difference. You see that this time, what you concatenate is not an int primitive type, but an integer, a wrapper type. What are the performances of these? Let us begin with the integer.toString pattern. It takes 19 nanoseconds on my machine. Well, that's not too bad. Let us take a look at the frowned upon pattern. Concatenation of an empty string with a primitive type. 11 nanoseconds on my machine. Wow, that's almost twice as fast. And what if you change this int primitive type to an integer wrapper type? This nice and fast 11 nanoseconds is now 33 nanoseconds. So, if you decide to go for the ugly pattern, you'd better double-check your code and make sure that no sneaky autoboxing invited itself in it. As you can see, with the JDK 8, your best bet is to not listen to your code reviewer in that case, because in fact, that ugly code is also the fastest. There are good reasons for that. But be careful, because if what you concatenate is not an int, like it's an integer or an object, then it's another story, and you're in trouble, because now your code is slower than the clean one. Where does the difference come from? On an integer, you need to call the toString method, and that's a polymorphic call that can even be a megamorphic call. So, you don't lose that much time, I mean, it's only 20 nanoseconds, but it's still a factor of 3. Here are the numbers with the JDK 17. A lot of work has been done here, and every pattern is in fact as fast as the other, which is awesome. And what you really get here is a double benefit. The first one is better performances, whatever pattern you chose in the first place. The second one is you don't need to rewrite your code when you move from 8 to 17, because what you get is better performances in all the cases. And this is exactly what you want. From a performance point of view, whatever you wrote is the right thing. Last point I would like to show you is string formatting. String formatting is quite complex. There are many elements that you can format: integers, floating point numbers, dates, times, and even plain strings of characters. And there are many ways to format all these elements, which adds complexity. And on top of that, each locale has its own formatting rules. So if you want to bench all that, well, that will be a lot of work. So from all this, I would like just to take a few examples to give you an idea of what you can expect. On the most complex formats, you can expect up to 15% of performance gain. It's the case for this date formatting or for the formatting of the pi number with some kind of tricky alignment. If you take a simpler format for your floating point numbers or for your integers, you may get a better performance gain. On this example, it's about 20 to 25%. But the best performance gain you may get is on simple cases. For this simple string formatting, the gain is almost a factor of 3, which is absolutely awesome. As you can see, moving to a recent version of the JDK brings you better performances without even touching your code. And with this, I'm out of coffee. So that's it for today. Talk to you soon.